Hey loves, welcome back to my YouTube video. Today's video is sponsored by Marquis Elliott. He gave me the topic to do. He's actually talking about it in his live, so I gotta give credit when credit's due. So basically he was speaking about God, and if you guys wanna go look at his live, I can pin it in the comments for y'all to go look at his live. He's on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. But basically I said in the comments to him, I don't know if he read my comment, but I said the answer to everything is God, because he is the key. So what I mean by God is the key and he's the answer to everything, because when you go into situations in your life, God has the answer to it. So he has a solution and everything. Everything that you can't figure out, God has the answer to it. So all you have to do is pray and ask for clarification when things are not making sense, or you can't seem to picture or understand it, if I'm making sense here. So you have to ask God to give you the ability to understand what's going on in every aspect of your life. So, yeah, if you're confused about your marriage, if you're confused about school, you're confused about your relationship, your finances, your bills, your kids, anything, majority, just tell God that, hey, I'm confused about this. Can you give me the answer to this? Now, when he gives you the answer, he might make you wait because it's more to the answer. Or he might just give you right then and there the answer to your situation. And when he gives you that answer, thank him, because if it wasn't for God, he could have left you confused and you would have never got an answer. But since God is the source and he's your provider, he will give you the answer to every question that you have, better than anybody else can, because most people don't be wanting to give you the answer to some questions, and that's why we have God. He's going to give us the answer to everything. Like, you might not be right there and there, but as he said, you don't understand what I'm doing now, but you will later on. So I'm gonna look for that Bible verse. But yeah, he basically been saying that you don't understand what I'm doing now, but you will later on, something like that. But yeah, let's see. You don't understand what I'm doing now. I think that someday you will. Something like that. Bible verse. Let's see. It's something. Something like that. So I think it's John. I'll put this down in the comments too. So I think it's John 13:7, and it says, "You do not realize what I'm doing, but later you will understand." So you may not know why situations are the way they are, or why they turned out the way they turned out, but that's why you leave God to figure that out for you, because he knows the answer to why the situations aren't out like that for you, or he knows why they got cheated, or he knows why that friend walked out on you. He knows every single thing. So when you allow God to figure out these problems for you, that takes less stress off of you. You don't have to worry about it or be stressed like, oh my God. And, you know, just worrying about every single thing in life. When you give your problems to God, you don't have to really necessarily worry about, you know, everything that goes on, because, like I said, he will give you the clarification and the answer that you needed, that you need in life. So, you know, you won't have to be so anxious and going to sleep tossing, turning, and worrying. Oh my God, how's the situation going to work? Oh my God, how am I going to be able to feed my kids? Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. You're just stressing and turning and trying to find these answers when God is looking at you and saying, you don't understand what I'm doing now, but later on you will. So, meaning he's working that situation out for you. You don't have to worry about nothing. I don't even know why we worry about stuff when God is always working stuff out. I don't even know why I worry about anything when God is always working it out. Stuff I'm saying to y'all, I should be saying to myself, because at the end of the day, I worry a lot. So, but why should I have to worry when there is a God? Why should I have to be you know, upset. Why should you have to be upset when God is working? You don't have to be concerned or worried or anxious about nothing. If God wanted you to be concerned about everything, he wouldn't be here. It wouldn't be no such thing as God if he wanted you to worry. He's here because he don't want you to worry about nothing. He wants you to surrender to him and not worry about nothing. Be okay. He wants you to live a happy and calm life. Not live a life where you're worried, stressed out, anxious. Oh my God, I don't know. He don't want you to live a life like that. He wants you to be at peace. You know how y'all see people on vacations and they be in the movies, they be on vacation, they be stress-free, they ain't worried about nothing. That's the type of life God wants us to live. Like, not be worried about nothing, not be anxious. If we worry so much, that'll mess up everything. That'll mess up our face, you know. We are beautiful, just so that'll mess up our face, that'll mess up us personally, because we're stressing about situations that we should have left to God. We're worried about stuff that we shouldn't even be worried about. You know, it'll work out in due time. One thing about God is he's not going to let the whole year go past without your prayers being answered. Just because they're not answered right then in that moment, he heard you. He hears you every day, every second. So never think that he is not listening or he's not aware of what's going on, because he's definitely fully aware. He didn't forget about you. God remembers everything. He don't forget about none of his children, especially if you're talking to him every single day. Why will he, you know what I'm saying, forget about you? And it be some moments where I think God has forgotten about me, and God reminds me every single day. My child, I've never forgotten about you. My child, I heard you. My child, I'm here to rescue you. My child, your answers are on the way. He's saying the same things to you as he's saying to me. He is not forgotten about you. So don't let nobody convince you or make you think, oh my God, he forgot about me. No, God is not like people. People forget about you. People that forget about you, they didn't want to remember you to begin with. Because why you want to forget about me for? Especially if I was a good person to you. But the thing about it is, like I said, God is not going to forget about you. God does not say, okay, well, I'm not going to bless her today. You waking up is the first blessing you receive. So if you woke up, that's a clear indication that God remembers you. Because why would God wake you up and not remember you? So if he woke you up today, that means he didn't forget about you. You were on his list to wake up this morning. You were on his list to sleep through the whole night and wake up the next morning. So he has not forgotten about you. Don't let nobody convince you, oh, well, you can't see him, so he forgot about you. People say anything just to get your mind off him. No, don't let nobody get your mind off God. Get around people that'll make you think about God 24/8. I don't care if y'all not at church. I don't care if you is at home. I don't care if you at a party. I don't care where you at. Don't forget about God at the end of the day. I don't care if you at work. I don't care if you at school. I don't care if you talking to one of your professors. I don't care who you talking to. At the end of the day, don't sit up there and put God last. And don't forget about him, because he never forgets about you. Him waking you up, you think he say, oh, I got to think about wake her up first. No. Or I got to think about waking him up first. I got to see if they going to make a mistake. No, he not doing none of that. God knows you're going to make a mistake, and he also knows that you're going to repent. So, not saying that it's okay to keep making mistakes, but he wants you to learn from what you do. He don't want you to keep making the same decision, the same mistake, that same error again. He wants you to learn. That's why he's building you up every single day. My child has to get up today. My child has a testimony. My child calling. She has a calling on her life, or he has a calling on his life. I have to make sure that they get up. I have to make sure that they spread my word. That's why I'm spreading his word every single day. I'm pulling y'all closer to him. So come on, subscribe to this channel. You know you want to subscribe. You know you want to be closer to God. You know ain't nothing worked out for you. You know ain't none of the stuff that you did, no matter who you went to, is your life was still in crumbles. Everything was just falling so much apart. But you study trying to go over here and go over there when you should be going right to the source. God is waiting on you. You don't have to dress fancy and do your hair, none of that. You don't got to do none of that dumb stuff. You don't have to fix your hair. You don't have to do none of that. Come as you are to God and surrender your life and say, God, I'm here. looking crazy, whatever. God see you when you're looking crazy anyway. So it don't matter how you come. Long as you come, you're there. So it don't matter if your hair not done. Most of the time, my hair ain't done, but I still go to God. My hair ain't done right now. It might look like my hair is done, but my hair ain't done. I ain't been to the salon. Who? I would tell y'all if I went to the salon. My hair is not done. It might look that way, but I ain't went to nobody's salon to get my hair done. So, no. You know, I don't tell God, oh, I'm a perfect person and you just gotta bless me today. No. I tell God, I know I made mistakes, but humble me and make me see not to make those same mistakes again. I want to be better and be a better woman. I am 26 years old. I'm going to make mistakes in life, but I'm also learning from each mistake that I'm doing in this life that I'm living. I'm learning from these mistakes, and I'm just here to tell you that no matter where you go in life or no matter what hits you, know that God is there right with you. So whatever's pulling you down today, God is pulling you right up today. This Bible is so powerful. Carry this. Get you a Bible to school, and every time you feel afraid, pull it out. Because fear is the devil. So pull this Bible out. The moment you pull it out, the fear will go away. You won't be scared of anything because God is with you. I'm telling y'all, when I hug this Bible, I be at peace. Like, my whole heart just go into peace mode. Like, it just be all right. Everything just be all right. When as soon as I pull out my Bible, everything that I was so worried about, it be okay. God wants you to know that He's here for you. God has never left your side. He never will. God is so amazing. So, download child Bible songs, and even if it's not Sunday, you can worship God every day. I don't know why people wait till it gets Sunday anyway. Why are you waiting till it gets Sunday? Why you can't love Him on Monday or Thursday, like today, Thursday? Why you can't love Him on a Friday night? Why you can't love Him on a Saturday morning? Why you can't love Him each and every day? God loves you each and every day. He don't say, oh, I'm just going to love Him for Sunday get here. Or I'm going to just love her. Love Him when Sunday get here. He don't wait till a specific day to get here and then say He loves you. No, God loves you every single day. So you want God to choose you every day, chose Him every day then. Okay, it's not I'm not feeling her right now. I ain't finna wake her up today. Oh, I'm gonna let her just sit here and be stuck. Or I'm just sit here and just let her be upset. No, or let Him be upset. Because I know a lot of men watch me, so I'm just going to let Him sit here and be upset. No, I don't care if you're 61 and you're watching me. You're still His child at the end of the day. It don't matter how old you get. Your age does not matter. You're still God's child. So, your age is just a number. But your heart is what God is looking at. And He knows your heart is good. He created your heart. He made your heart. So, He knows what your heart can hold, and He knows that you can hold. That's why He made you strong, and He tell you, you can get through that hard work. You don't want to get through it, but you're going to get through it because I'm going to help you get through it. You're letting these people convince you that you can't get through it, but you have me. I'm the most powerful equipment that you can have. I'm the most powerful tool there is. So you mean to tell me you can't get through this situation? You mean to tell me you can't beat this cancer? You mean to tell me you can't overcome this anxiety? You mean to tell me you can't overcome this abusive relationship? This man beating on you, you can't walk out this relationship and be happy with someone else? The devil is a lie, because you can walk out. If you're not satisfied and your man is not pleasing you in the way you want to be pleased, you have a right to leave. You don't have to stay where you're not happy at. Okay, don't ever stay where you're not happy at or where you're not wanting it. If that man is not doing something that he's supposed to do for you, then leave. God wants us to be happy, not sad and miserable. The devil wants you sad and miserable. God doesn't. So at the end of the day, when you're feeding your flesh, feed it positive thoughts. Feed it the word of God. Feed it positive energy. Okay? Feed the positive energy. The more you be around positive people, and the more you feed your soul and your spirit positive energy, you become positive. you become someone a lot of people want to be around. Okay, a lot of people want to be around positive people. A lot of people want to be around bosses. You a boss. You just gotta go do the work. You're a boss. You're not a nobody. You're a somebody. So remember those things. Remember three things. First, your God shall. Second, God is the powerful tool here. Third, you are wonderfully made. Remember these three things. Okay? I love you guys. And I want you guys to be the best young woman and man, even older woman and man. Be the best that you can be in this thing called life. If you love this video, give me a big thumbs up. I'm not going to make it long. I'm thinking about going live for you guys to talk to y'all. If y'all want to see that, let me know that in the comments or just leave me a thumbs up. I feel like this was a good video and I feel like it was, I explained a lot here. So if you guys liked it, give me a thumbs up, as I said, and subscribe here if you're new. I know we got a new subscriber this one. I would like to personally welcome her to the channel. Kiara, I would like to welcome you, if I'm saying your name correctly. Kiara, I would like to personally welcome you to my channel. I hope your spirit is uplifted, and I hope you come back to watch more vlogs from me. And you guys, I'm thinking about doing a Vlogmas. So if I do a Vlogmas, would you guys watch that? Let me know down in the comments if I start a Vlogmas. I know a lot of YouTubers are talking about Vlogmas is like really tomorrow. So if I like do one tomorrow for you guys, would you guys want to see that? Let me know down in the comments. Feel free to hit me through Instagram and, you know, chat with me. Let me know. More topics, you guys want to see more videos, more content. So, yeah, bye, loves.